Samaveda has got three divisions, the Purvarchika, the Mahanamni, and the Uttararchika. As the term indicates, the Purvarchika must be prior to Uttararchika. So I just tried to learn the differences between these three sections. It is a long process of research study, but I will just condense it into a few words, which is important from the musical point of view. Now, in Purvarchika, there is a definite relationship between the swara and the chandas. And that law of relationship is very well preserved by all the rishis belonging to the Purvarchika period. No one has changed it. Now, what is that relationship? They use all the seven swaras. In Purvarchika itself, all the seven swaras are used. For Gayatri, they always use Shajja. And for Brihati, they use Madhyama. And for Trishtupu, they use Daivata. For Jagati, they always use Nishada. For Anushtupu, they always use Gandhara. And for Ushnik, that is always Rishabha. And Panti and Mahapanti, they use Panchama. Then there are a few lesser known or apradhana chandas like Ashti, Atyashti, Atishakwari, etc. For Ashti, they use Madhyama. For Atyashti, they use Gandhara. And for Adishakwari, they use Panchama. This is the law that is followed in Purvarchika, which is probably the earliest part of Samaveda. And, you know, if you look at the number of akshara, number of letters in each of these, starting from Gayatri, that is 24 letters for three pada of Gayatri with 8 letters in each pada, it is 24 letters, up to Jagadi. Jagadi has got 48 letters in 4 pada with 12 letters each. So from Gayatri to Jagadi, that is from 24 to 48, the difference is again 24. It is actually the double of Gayatri. The seventh one is double from the first one. This Shruti Niyama, you know, this Shruti Niyama is followed in music even nowadays. Now, in the earlier scriptures and texts, we find that there had been more than 100 branches for Samaveda. Patanjali in Mahabhashya says, Sahasravarma Samaveda, 1000 shakas, branches for Samaveda. And in the Buddhist text, it is said 1080 shakas are there, branches are there for Samaveda. But at present, we have only 2. All the others we have lost. These 2, the Kauthumi and Jaiminiya, are the things. And you know, Jaimini was the disciple of Vyasa. So after Vyasa is the Jaiminiya shakha. And that shakha is, I'm not going into the details of that shakha, but Kauthumi and Jaiminiya has got some small differences. These are the 2 shakhas that we have now. And if we look into the Namas, the Rishis, the Kauthuma, Satyam, Ugra and Laugachara, that is the, this belong to the Udicha Shakha belonging to Jaimini. These 3 shakhas, which are mentioned in the Buddhist scriptures, in Purvarchika, there is only 3 mantra belonging to this Udicha Shakha Rishi, that is Usidhikarna. Just 1 Rishi's 3 mantra only exist in the presently available Purvarchika, which belongs to the Buddhist period. All the others are before Buddhist period. And in these 3 mantra which Usidhikarna uses, all the 3 are in Gayatri and all use Shajja as Swara, and for all the Devata is Indra. in Prachya Shakha, there is just one mantra belonging to the Vatayana Shakha. That is the Vatayana Ula. Probably that is the Shakha belonging to the older. Vatayana is the older Shakha of Hanumat Swami. So just one older mantra which has been repeated and which has been used even during the Buddhist. So after Buddhist, you can't say a new mantra has been added to the Samaveda. The Buddhist uses this Samaveda, but no new rishi, no new mantra has been added after the Buddhist period. All the rishis which are present in the Purvarchika are before Vyasa, before the Mahabharata, and they are, most of them are mentioned in the Surya, Chandra and Agni Vamsha of the Purana and Itihasa, and they also belong to the Rigvedic Rishi Parampara. So all these Acharyas belong to Gurukulas who existed before Vyasa. That is the conclusion that we have to arrive at. And you know, the Vyasa's period is almost the same as that of Krishna. And that is about BC 3104 is the time of beginning of Kali Yuga. And if you go into the archaeological evidence, it is almost corresponding to the Indus Valley Harappan period, no? So all these rishis were before the Indus Valley Harappan period is the conclusion that you have to get into. It is just before that, according to the scriptures, scriptural and literary knowledge. And if you look into the archaeological evidences, this has to be before that. All the rishis are before the Indus Valley Harappan period. And coming to Mahanamya Archika, it is a very small piece. And it is in between the Uttararchika and Purvarchika. And there are only 10 mantras in this. Very small, very short. And the important thing is that there are only 4 rishis for these 10 mantras. They are Indra, Prajapati, Vishnu and Vishwamitra. All are very, very ancient people. And in Purvarchika, you find stutis to Indra. Indra is worshipped as one of the deities. But Indra is never a rishi in Purvarchika. In Mahanamni, Indra is a rishi. So Mahanamni has to be older than Purvarchika. That rishi, that Purviga rishi, is being venerated as a deity by the time of Purvarchika. So Mahanamni, which contains only 10 mantra, must be earlier than Purvarchika. So also Prajapati and Vishnu. Vishnu as a rishi. That's a very, very ancient thing, no? And also Vishwamitra, the Rigvedic rishi, also is a rishi in Mahanamni. In Purvarchika, there are 2 mantras which are Prajapati Para. The rishi for one is Vamadeva, for the other is Vishwamitra, never Prajapati. So Prajapati as a rishi also comes only in Mahanamni, not in Purvarchika. And in Purvarchika, there is Vishnu or Narayana as a rishi. There are 5 mantra to Purusha, that's the Purusha Sutta, in Gandharaswaram, in Anishtup. This we have to compare with Mahanamni. Vishnu is a rishi in Mahanamni as well. And ultimately, when you go into this, as I said earlier, Vishnu as the most ancient rishi of the music, the Kaishiki Vritti, Vishnu as the oldest rishi who produced music of the country, is shown even by the rishi parampara in the Mahanamni and Purvarchika itself. Vishnu as a rishi, as a woman, as a greatest Bhishagvara, the Siddhideva who protects everything, producing Sama Sangeeta, Sama music, for the preservation of the entire biodiversity of the world, the cosmic universe. That concept is there in even Mahanamni, which is the oldest collection of 10 verses only we have got about it. Then comes Purvarchika. Even in that, you find this, the same concept. Then comes Uttararchika. Now, Uttararchika has got a very very, very different way in that it has changed the law. The law of the relationship between the swara and the chandas is changed by the time of Uttararchika. As we said, for Gayatri always Shadja is used. But in Uttararchika, we find one rishi. The name of the rishi is Brihanmati. This rishi, Brihanmati, he uses both Madhyama and Shadja for the Gayatri. So he had made a change in the originally existing law. And who is this Brihanmati? Brihanmati, the great mind is the word. The great, Brihat is the great, Shalamai. That great mind, the Brihanmati. And Mati is a term or a title used for great teachers in both Valabi and Nalanda University. And if you look into the Mushaka Vansha Kavya, we will find a person called Mahamati. And this Mahamati of the Mushaka Vansha must be the Brihanmati. That is what I feel. Because from the entire scriptures, I can find only that name of that old period. Mahamati is the Brihanmati from the Mushaka Vansha Kavya. That person must be the Brihanmati Rishi who made this change in his repertoire of music. So from that day onwards, the Gandharva Veda has started to have its own musical changes, changing the system from the originally existing Samaveda law from that day onwards. Now the second change we find is Vibhrat Saurya. That is the Rishi's name. A Rishi called Vibhrat Saurya, in a mantra to sun, he changes the usual Nishada of Jagadi into Shadja. So another change, another experimental change into the musical part of Gandharva Veda is made by Vibhrat Saurya. Then we find Vasushruta Atreya, belonging to the Atreya Kula. He gives, instead of, you know, for Pankti it is Panchama, usual law. Instead of Panchama, he uses Shadja. So another alteration. And finally, Aujathyan, he is also called Dirghatamas. He uses Panchamam in the place of Rishabha for Ushnik. So four changes we find. And of this we know Dirghatamas was a Ayurveda Acharya as well as a Rigvedic Rishi and the king of Kashi. So at least two of them are royal family, the Audatya as well as Brihanmati from Mushaka Vamsha and the Kashi Raja Vamsha. So at least two. Anyway, the change has occurred from the routine law for the seven swaras and for the seven chandas. And this shows the beginning of the musical sampradaya called Graha Bheda, Swara Bheda, etc. So this Graha Bheda, Swara Bheda sampradaya has started right from the period of Uttararchika. It is not seen in Swararchika, in the Purvarchika or Mahanamini. There the law is followed. So it is older. Purvarchika, the oldest is actually Mahanamini from the rishis. And then the Purvarchika, in both the seven swaras are used in Purvarchika, but there is no Swara Bheda or Graha Bheda. But by the time of Uttararchika, both Swara Bheda and Graha Bheda has become a rule. And in Purvarchika, all the rishis in Purvarchika and the devadas in Purvarchika are again repeated in Uttararchika because the tradition is repeated. But along with that, about 36 new rishis are seen in Uttararchika, showing that they are new people in the same Gurukula, living in a different time span. So it is these people who have changed and made the Gandharva Veda from Sama Veda. And many of the newer people, the chronology, if you look into the chronology of the Purana and Itihasa, you can actually compile the Rachana Kala or the time of creation of the Uttararchika, a general idea about the time of creation of the Uttararchika period. And since there are the hundred Vaighanasa were present during, even during the Purvarchika period, the Vaighanasa Sampradaya of bhajans of the Vaishnava, the singing of the Vaighanasa Sampradaya of the Vaishnava is actually very early. And the Vaighanasa Rishi is not a male. Vaighanasa Rishi, the 100 Vaighanasa Rishis are females. So Kaishiki Vritti, the female Vaighanasa Sampradaya, which is very early, the Mahanamni Sampradaya, which is that of the females, which is the earliest. Then comes the Purvarchika with the said rules. Then last, the Uttararchika, where the new rishis are added, the new Grahabheda Swarabheda system is added. So we can actually trace the history of these changes and trace the history of the musical traditions from these three divisions of Samaveda itself.